Hey kids, tonight we're making hamburger steak.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
I'm gonna do a small batch of hamburger steak. And this can be adapted, of course, to any size. I just happen to be making it just for myself. So you put flour into your little bowl there. I'm just gonna hit it with just a tiny bit of this light salt and some pepper because I really like pepper. And I'm gonna mix that in there just a little bit. And then you take your hamburger. I have my organic pan already on the stove, heating up at medium heat, that it does not go above. And I'm gonna take my hamburger and I am going to form it into a circle, but I'm gonna make it like in a donut shape, just so that the inside of it will also cook at the same rate of speed like the rest. So where's my little donut hole? That's kind of falling apart. I didn't give it enough time. Let's mix it up somewhat better. I usually like to not play with it too much because you don't want to toughen it up much. And I don't know how true that is, but once I hear somebody say something like that, I always just freak out that, ooh, I'm going to toughen things up. So there's my hole. And all I'm going to do is coat both sides. So I obviously put way too much flour in here since I'm just cooking for me. It's hard, you know, when you are used to cooking for three and then all of a sudden you're just doing one tiny little batch. So I'm going to just go throw that into the frying pan and it's going to do its own magic there. However, while that's going on, we're going to come back over here and we are going to cut up our little sweet onion into our little onion rings and get that ready for the next step. All right, I did put a little bit of oil in there, and you don't have to use oil in these organic pans. That's what, you know, they're specialized for, but I decided to go ahead and do this anyway because I'm going to be adding in the onions and I want the onions to have a little bit of, you know, stuff, and I also want their, you know, the flour to give me a good gravy there at the end. So let's go back and get those onions done and we'll be adding them in shortly. I love that this recipe just calls for a couple of ingredients. It just makes it so much easier. I'm not a real super fan of onions, so that is going to be more than enough onions for me. And the side that I have cooking right now should pretty much be ready to turn over. So I'm going to go ahead, go over and flip that over since we just really want to brown each side for just a couple of minutes because we're going to add the stuff in and then we're going to cook it some more. And we should be able to flip that guy over there. And we'll let that go for a couple of minutes. But while that's going for the couple of minutes, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add in these onions over onto the side here. And we're gonna allow them to cook down. We wanna get them to where they're nice and soft and the edges have gotten a little brown. So we're keeping it at the medium heat, like our Greenix asked for. Suppose I should have clarified, I'm not a super fan of you know, grilled onions, not onions themselves. I love onions. Maybe just about as much as I love garlic. Alright, they're starting to look very nice. If you did add oil at this point, you can try and get rid of as much as you can. I went in there with a paper towel and What we're going to do is we're just going to add in about a cup of beef broth. And we're going to cover this and we're going to let it continue to cook for about 10 minutes. And it should be done. So we'll be back. And there it is. It's nice and done. I might thicken this gravy up just a little bit by putting in a little bit of a little bit more flour. There you go. Hamburger steak. Enjoy.
Goodbye. Make sure you comment and subscribe, and it would be so great if you favorite